back to the Hua March shooting range here in Bangkok, Thailand for the last final of the day, 50-meter rifle, three positions men. It's been an exciting day here in Bangkok watching these talented athletes who have been invited here to strive forward for one last fight for the gold for the 2012 ISSF season. I'm Hillary Russell, and I've had the pleasure to follow these fine shooters throughout the 2012 World Cup season and then to the Olympic Games, and I can guarantee that it'll be more than exciting to see who will end up on the podium for the last 2012 ISSF competition. And with me, I have USA's 2005 World Cup final gold medalist Semprone, as well as former three-piece shooter Eric Updegraft with me today. Welcome, Eric, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
It's a warm one here today.
It's been warm every day we've been here so far.
It certainly has. And we'll have just a couple minutes. We'll have a chance to introduce the eight finalists today. We were talking a couple minutes about the shooting range, Eric. Do you like it here?
It's a nice range. I'd like to come shooting again, but I don't know if they have a cool season. It'd be nice if it was a little cooler.
I think it's hot and raining season here, and that's about it.
Hot and I think so.
Yeah.
Makes Fort Benning seem cool.
Everybody's heard it right off the lips of Eric Updegraft, Fort Benning cool. So here are our eight finalists today.
And the International Shooting Sports Federation welcomes you to the Thai National Shooting Range. The final competition for the 50 marathon rifle team position men event will now begin.
In eighth place, coming in with 1,158 points, representing Switzerland, we have Simon Baylor.
Representing Switzerland, he got a bronze medal in World Cup Munich 2012. Please welcome Barbara Simon.
In seventh place, coming in with 1,158 points, representing Slovenia, we have Raymond Debevic. And Raymond yesterday won the gold medal during the prone.
Yes, now that he's getting older, he's becoming a good prone shooter.
What, he won the bronze medal during prone as well? And now
yep.
Here he is again, won another competition. In sixth place, coming with 1,159 points, representing the Ukraine, we have Sergei Kulish. Only 19 years old, but this kid is up and coming, Eric.
Definitely a good shooter. Seen him for a couple years now.
In fifth place, coming with 1,163 points, representing Norway, we have Ole Magnus Bakken. Another young guy, but we've seen what he can do.
Absolutely.
And in fourth place today, with 1,163 points, representing Serbia, Nemanja Mirosavljev. Nicest guy in the world.
He is. I've known him for 20 years. We call him Slim.
Slim. I'll tell you, a couple years ago with that last name, I wanted to call him Slim too. In third place, coming with 1,166 points, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Jinseop Han.
Yeah, real good prone shooter and three-piece shooter.
Very, very talented, in fact. In second place, coming in with 1,167 points, representing Norway, we have Ole Kristian Bryhn.
Yeah, another young up-and-coming shooter.
Got a lot of young ones down there today.
They sure are. They have been all year.
That's true.
Except for Raymond.
Except for Raymond.
And Jason.
And in first place, coming in with 1,171 points, representing the United States of America, we have Jason Parker.
Of course, I'm biased. I'm hoping he'll win.
Of course. And he pretty much has a good chance of that if he can just shoot deep. And he's got a four-point advantage over the others. So that's definitely working to his side.
Absolutely.
So tell me, Eric, how does it feel to be invited to a World Cup final?
It's kind of like a validation of your year. This wasn't my best year, but it still feels really good to be invited to come to this match, mm-hmm. and you know you're shooting against the best, so it's like a capstone event of the year.
Right. And after this, what are your plans?
I'll take a little bit of time off and then get back at it.
And what time, more or less, what time during the year do you start to get into training again?
This year, probably December.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Probably take most of November off. I've got some vacation planned.
Yeah.
And then we'll get back at it. Our first big match in the U.S., well, sort of big match in the U.S., is in February. So
okay.
In Colorado Springs, so it's indoors.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes.
Very nice. And starting in December, about how many times a week do you start training?
Oh, it'll be at least 5 times a week.
And how many hours?
I'm just shoot prone these days, so not as many as it used to be, but I'll shoot at least an hour a day, maybe mm-hmm. more, depending on how it's going.
Right. And do you feel pretty confident for 2013? I mean, we all know that the rules are changing.
Sure.
And so things are going to be a little bit different. What are your thoughts on that?
It'll be interesting. Hopefully it's good for the sport. Jason Parker went over to Munich a week ago and did the test of the three-position final. He really enjoyed it. He thought it was interesting to watch and interesting to shoot. So mm-hmm. should be a lot of fun.
We did. We had quite a good feedback from that, actually. So hopefully the shooters will, you know, be able to get back into a different groove, and that'll be good for everybody.
Yeah, it'll probably play to different people's strengths instead of just the really good air rifle shooters dominating three position. It might, you know, go back to, you know, standing isn't your best event. You still got a chance.
Right.
So the way it used to be.
I've always been interested to watch. I would love to see a match of all of you guys without your gear on and see what the outcome would be.
You know, with a little training, it'd probably be okay, but I think long-term injuries and stuff, back injuries, would probably become an issue.
Right. Of course, I mean, the jacket, you definitely need that for your support for your back. But I would love to see what the scores would be just one time, not forever.
Just as an interesting side note, Raymond Debevic set the world record and finals world record 20 years ago at World Cup Finals, so he's going to be retiring one record here once we switch over to the new finals.
That's true. Everything will start up clean and new all over again.
Yep.
20 years ago, that's a long time ago.
That's a long time to hold a record.
I know, it really is. There are some of these events that you see, and it's like back in 1986 also. I can't remember who it was. I believe it was 86. Don't quote me on it, but some of these records go back a long, long time ago.
Yeah, I mean, the prone record lasted for 16 years until Martinoff broke it this summer.
Right.
So he doesn't get to hold it for very long.
Yeah, it's a shame that he wasn't able to make it here after winning the gold in London. So here we go. Let's focus in here on Baylor and Debevic. Oh, 8.7. That is kind of a surprise.
Yeah. Sometimes it takes a little while to settle into a final.
Yeah, I'm sure that it does. And, you know, the shooters that I've spoken with, they always say it's the first shot and then down to the last few shots that, you know, you got to get settled in, and then the nerves kind of kick in. And 9.4 for Baylor. So let's take a look at the standings now. Parker shot a 10.3. Bryhn a 9.0. Han a 10.2. Miroslavljev a 10.7. Back in an 8.2. Kulish a 9.3. Debevic a 8.7. And Baylor a 9.4. Parker has now up to his lead. He's now 5.1 tenths of a point ahead of the others. Han is in second place, and 2 tenths of a point behind him is Bryhn. Miroslavljev is 2.2 tenths of a point now behind Bryhn. Early in, things can change around.
Oh, absolutely. In standing finals, well, it's not quite as bad as free pistol, but standing, just about anything can happen.
That's right. And we're going to be moving on to the second shot here. And let's just focus in on Kulish and Bakken. Now, Kulish, I believe, is 19 years old.
He is.
And he's just had a banner year this year. You know, there's a couple people that are here that I'm saying, you know, keep your eyes on them, because you're going to see that they're going to really go far in this sport, without a doubt.
Yes.
9.9 for Kulish, back in a 10.1. Nice 10.5 for Parker.
That's a good start for his final.
Just waiting now for Baylor. With a 9.9.
Result of the second shot. Parker
with a 10.5. Bryhn a 10.7. Han a 9.8. Mirosavljev a 9.3. Bakken a 10.1. Kulish a 9.9. Debevec a 10.5. And Baylor a 9.9. Parker still holding on to first place, still with 5.1 tenths of a point over Bryhn. Han is in third place now, 7 tenths of a point behind Bryhn. So we have a little flip there, and we have Bryhn has now overtaken Han. Miroslavyev is 3 points away from third place. So Parker is starting off quite well.
Yeah, that's always how you want to start a final. Want to start strong and carry it through.
Focusing in now on Mirosavljev and Han. 9.9 for Han. Mirosavljev a 10.4. An 8.1 there for Parker. You could see a little movement right there, right when he shot.
Yeah, just a little bit. Doesn't take much. Good thing you had 5.1.
That's true. It's always nice to have a good cushion going into things, you know?
Absolutely. It'll be different next year.
That's true. Absolutely.
Start at zero.
Baylor with a 10.7. So let's take a look here. We have Parker with an 8.1. Bryhn an 8.8. Han a 9.9. Mirosavljev a 10.4. Bakken with an unfortunate 8.0. Kulish a 10.1. Debevec a 9.4. And Baylor a 10.7. Parker still has the lead. He's lost his 1.1 tenth advantage. He now has 4 points ahead of Han. And Bryhn is in third place, 4 tenths of a point behind Han. Miroslavyev is 2.1 tenths of a point behind Bryhn.
Yeah, Slim's got a pretty good final going.
He certainly does.
Got a ways to make up.
Slim.
He's the nicest guy.
He certainly is.
3, 2, 1, start.
Back on now to Bryhn and Parker. Ten 10.1 for Bryhn. Nine 9.0 for Parker.
That's two in the row out the right for him, so could be the wind.
And I got your fingers crossed there. Han a 9.7, and just waiting now for Baylor. 10.6, it looked like it was pretty steady when he was just getting ready to shoot. So things are changing around just a little bit. This is after Parker shot a 9.0. Bryhn a 10.1, Han a 9.7. Mirosavljev an unfortunate 8.0 there. Bakken an 8.2. Kulish 10.3. Debevec a 10.4. And Baylor a 10.6. Parker's still holding on to first. He is now ahead by 3.3 tenths of a point over Han and Bryhn, who are now tied up neck to neck. 4.2 tenths of a point behind them, we have Miroslavyev.
So you know,
you know Jason better than probably anybody, you know, other than other people on the team.
Yes.
Can he mentally get it back together?
Oh, absolutely. He's as mentally tough as any of the shooters we had.
Mm-hmm.
Run into a rough patch, and that's how you reel back from that.
It's just to get back into the game. Yeah.
Yep. You just got to focus one shot at a time.
That's right. How do you guys do that? How do you get back into it?
Sometimes better than others. a lot of training.
Miroslavljev coming off an 8.0. Started off really strong. With a 10.1. 9.9 also for Parker, 9.5 for Bryhn. You can see that in Breen's face, he is sweating. You know, it's really, really warm down there. We're a little bit luckier up here. The air is a little bit cooler, but I would not want to be in all that gear that you guys wear and have to be in the heat.
You know, I've heard from some of the people that are coming back from Scandinavia, it's a huge temperature difference for them. I mean, it just started cooling off recently at Fort Benning, but it's still warm.
Right. Parker again, a couple tenths of a point there. He is ahead by 3.7 tenths of a point after shooting that 9.9. Bryhn, a 9.5. Han, a 9.0. Miroslavljev, a 10.1. We have Bakken with a 9.1. Kulish, 9.5. Devovec, a 10.1. And Baylor, a 9.3. Like I said, Parker is still holding in first. 3.7 tenths of a point over Bryhn, who's now overtaken Han. Han is in third place, only 5 tenths of a point behind Bryhn, and Miroslavljev is 3.1 tenths of a point behind third place.
Yeah, it just keeps going back and forth, second and third.
This is what we were seeing earlier today in the women's event, too.
Yeah, it was. Except for first place, no telling what was going to happen.
No, and it went down to the very last shot until we found out what was going to happen there. Let's focus in on Han right now. Fast shooter, 8.5. A 9.3 for Bryhn. Parker, an 8.2.
Yeah, not good. Miroslavljev, he's moving up fast.
He certainly is. The 10.4, that'll do it.
Yeah. Well, when everybody in front of you is, you gain a point.
Yeah.
At least a point on everybody.
Baylor, 9.9. And waiting now for Dubovic with a 9.9. Okay, again, the standings. Parker has 2.6 tenths of a point lead over Bryhn right now after shooting that 8.2, Bryhn with a 9.3, Han an 8.5, Miroslavljev a 10.4, Bakken a 9.3, Kulish a 10.2, Debevich a 9.9, and also a 9.9 for Baylor. So we have Bryhn in second place. Behind him now is Han with 1.3 tenths of a point. As you said earlier, or just a minute ago, Eric, with that 10.4, Miroslavljev is closing the gap. He's only 1.2 tenths of a point now behind third place. So.
Pretty exciting. It's always exciting to watch somebody moving up the rankings.
Okay, back on to Jason Parker from the U.S. Star. 9.2 for Parker.
It's getting pretty close.
It's getting very close right now with a 10.3 from Han. And Bryhn with a 10.5. Again, waiting on Baylor. And an 8.3. Let's take a look at the standings after shot 7. The gap between first and second place is getting a little bit
a little
slim
close
there.
Than I'd like.
Yeah, that was after Parker shot a 9.2. with Bryhn shooting a 10.5, Han a 10.3, Miroslaviev a 9.1, Bakken a 9.9, Kulish a 10.5, Dedelec a 8.5, and a Baylor 8.3. Parker still holding on to first by 1.3 tenths of a point over Bryhn. And a point and a half behind is Han. Miroslaviev is now dropped down a little bit. As far as his points go, he's 2.4 tenths of a point now behind Han.
Isn't it interesting how in the women's final there's four of them over a 100 final, and we've only really got one guy that's got a chance at it, and he's below the level right now.
We were just talking about that before this, about you were saying how there's quite a difference between the women's and men's event.
I don't know what it is. They're just, I don't know, meaner, tougher.
They're serious.
I don't know what it is, but
really serious.
You want to get out of their way when they shoot the final.
Back on to Parker. See if he can get back into the tens.
Yeah.
That's right. That's how you do it. A 10.8 for Parker.
That helps a lot.
Yes.
Especially with hand shooting a 10.7.
Mm-hmm. Bryhn with a 9.8. Han, as we said, a 10.7, and waiting now for Baylor. With a 10.7, getting right back into the game, coming off that 8.3 he had earlier. So let's see here. Parker is getting a couple more tenths of a point lead. He's now in the lead by 2.3 tenths over Bryhn. And that's after shooting a great 10.8. Bryhn, a 9.8. Han, 10.7. Miroslaviev, a 9.1. Bakken, 10.3. Kulish, also a 10.3. Devovich a 10.2, and Baylor a 10.7. Parker ahead by 2.3 tenths of a point over Bryhn. Han is only 6 tenths of a point now behind Bryhn, and Miroslaviev is now 4 points behind.
Yeah, so still tight between the second and third. Parker's extended his lead a little bit. I'd prefer it was 10 points, but I guess it makes it more exciting for everybody else.
That's true, for the spectators. I'm sure you guys as shooters probably don't find it that as exciting.
You know, big a lead, you know, some people say they like shooting from second place, less pressure. No, you always take a lead if you can keep it.
Han and Bryhn now, these two guys are only 6 tenths of a point behind. Bryhn with a 10.5, Han a 9.8. Parker a 9.8. Baylor. With an 8.7. Okay, 1.6 tenths of a point lead.
Okay, one shot to go.
One shot to go. Okay, we're going to have to talk about this in a second. 9.8 for Parker. Bryhn, a 10.5. Han, 9.8. Miroslaviev, a 10.8. Bakken, a 10.3. Also, Kulish with a 10.8. Dedelec, a 10.5. And Baylor, as we saw before, an 8.7. Parker's got 1.6 tenths of a point lead over Bryhn. Han, 1.3 tenths of a point behind him. And Miroslaviev, with that beautiful 10.8, has now dropped 1 point from third place. So, Eric, what do you think?
Well, I think he can do it. Just a good, solid 8.5 or better, and he's good to go.
Okay.
Hopefully he doesn't think of it that way.
Let's focus in then on Parker. And a 9.7 is going to be just enough for Parker to win the gold medal without a doubt. And I believe that Han is going to move up into second place.
I don't think Miroslaviev can overtake Bryhn.
Nope. And let's take a look at the standings here. Indeed, we do have Jason Parker, gold medalist, by 3 points in the end. Han finishing up in second place, overtaking Bryhn by a half a point. Miroslavyev, I've got to give him, you know, my credit. He did do a really great job. And there he is, our gold medalist for the World Cup final in three-position men, Jason Parker. Really, really great shooting, and he kept us on the edge of the seat without a doubt. Our silver medalist, Jinseop Han from the Republic of Korea, and on the last shot, Bryhn, Ole Kristian Bryhn from Norway, moved down into third place, but he's still on the podium. You know, very interesting final. As you were saying, the scores were a little bit lower than we may have expected, but, you know, they all did a fantastic job to get here, and I'm really glad that they did as well as they did.
Yeah, I'm really happy for Jason.
Me too.
This is his first World Cup final medal. He's always kind of escaped him, and so he's always been, it's one of his big goals, obviously Olympic medal, but this one is short, you know, falls a little bit behind that, but it's always been on his list.
Well, Eric, listen, I want to wish you the best fall. Have a nice relaxing time before you have to gear up for the 2013 season.
Well, thank you, Hillary.
And safe travels back home.
Appreciate you too.
Thank you.
The bronze medal goes to Bryhn Kristian from Norway with a total score of 10,263.8. To Han Jinseop from Korea with a total score of 9,263.5. The United States of America.